Hello. RWBY episode 8. Destiny.
It sounds good and bad. Kind of like the Destiny game. It's good and bad.
Alright, let's begin.
And millions of viewers say otherwise.
But Ying would never do that.
Yeah.
You all seem like good students. And the staff here at Beacon are fully aware that you would never lash out the way you did, under normal circumstances. What I believe and hope this to be is nothing more than the result of stress and adrenaline. When you're out on the battlefield, your judgment can become clouded in an instant. Sometimes you see things that simply aren't there. Even after the fight has passed.
But I wasn't.
That's enough! The sad truth is, whether it was an accident or an assault, it doesn't matter. The world saw you attack an innocent student. They've already drawn their own conclusions, and it's my job to inform you that you're disqualified.
You guys believe me, right?
Duh! You're hot-headed, but not ruthless.
Blake?
Uh-oh.
I want to believe you.
Huh? What's that supposed to mean?
Blake?
How can you say something like that? Ying would never lie to us.
I had someone very dear to me change. It wasn't in an instant, it was gradual. Little choices that began to pile up. He told me not to worry. At first they were accidents, then it was self-defense. Before long, even I began to think he was right. This is all just very familiar. But you're not him. And you've never done anything like this before. So, I want to trust you. I will trust you. But first, I need you to look me in the eyes and tell me that he attacked you. I need you to promise me that you regret having to do what you did. I saw him attack me, so I attacked back. Okay. Thank you.
Wow.
I think I'm gonna rest up. We'll get out of your hair.
This is a mess.
Is she doing okay?
Hey.
She's doing the best she can.
I heard Mercury and his team rush back to Haven to be with his family. So until they land, no one can really question him about what happened.
If there's anything we can do, please don't hesitate to ask.
Track him down.
All right, then. If that's the case, Hira? You be sure to win one for Beacon, okay? It's what Ying would want.
Yeah.
I'll do my best.
I'll be sure to watch tonight in case you're picked!
Sorry, but I think I've had enough fighting for 1 year.
Ditto.
What did she?
We gotta get your butt in shape for the big fight. It could be today. It could be tomorrow. It could be a fucking party.
So our hammer does weigh 1,000 pounds.
Right. You can't let anything hold you back. Focus. You'll be defending the honor of Beacon Academy.
Of course.
This blend of herbs and vegetables is filled with nutrients vital to your body's well-being.
Oh,
please. There's no need to thank me.
Thank you? Ugh, that looks like slime from a lake bed.
Algae contains numerous spectacular properties. See for yourself.
Oh, gosh.
What is wrong with you?
Me? You're the one that wasted perfectly good juice.
We're supposed to help her and not poison her.
There was absolutely nothing wrong with that.
John's just standing there.
Coming up as it has going down, then there's something wrong.
Hey, how about we all get some fresh air?
I think he's taking notice.
Why not? It is. Something's up.
You know, that's what I mean. I've heard.
Mm-hmm. Hey there, Firecracker.
Hey!
Hey, Crow.
So, why'd you do it?
You know why.
All I know is that you attacked a helpless kid. So either you're lying, or you're crazy.
I'm not lying.
Crazy.
Who knows? Maybe I am.
And here I thought your dark-haired friend was the emo one.
I saw my mom.
What?
I was in a lot of trouble. Took a pretty hard hit. But when I came to, the person attacking me was gone. And I thought I saw her. Her sword, like the one in you and Dad's old picture.
You're not crazy, Yang. That was your mom, all right. Let me guess. She didn't say a word, did she?
How did you know that?
I don't see my sister very often, but she does try to keep in touch whenever it suits her.
So they know she's
alive. Wait, you mean you talked to her? That was real?
Yeah, she found me. Had a tip for my most recent assignment, and wanted me to give you a message.
Why didn't you tell me sooner?
I was trying to wait for the right time, and this sure ain't it. But I guess you deserve to know. She wanted me to tell you that she saved you once, but you shouldn't expect that kindness again. Raven's got an interesting way of looking at the world that I don't particularly agree with. And she's dangerous. But you're a tough egg, kiddo. Shouldn't let this tournament thing get you down. You had a slip-up. Sometimes bad things just happen. I say it's time you move on.
Move on to what?
Well, Raven let some info slip before she took off. If you ever want to track her down... I think I might be able to help.
Didn't you just say she's dangerous?
Maybe not the kind of person you want Yang to be mentored by.
The leaves are falling. Oh, gosh. The symbolism couldn't be more punching you in the face.
Unless the leaf hit her in the face.
It's no green goo, but I think it still might do some good.
Right. Thank you, Jean.
Come on, men. Let's go back to the fairgrounds. I'll leave another stuff in.
You were the first person to ever believe in me. You know that? Even when I told my parents I was going to Beacon. They told me not to worry if I ended up having to move back home. How depressing is that?
I'm sure they didn't mean...
I guess I'm just trying to say that you've always been there for me, even when I didn't deserve it. And I can tell there's something on your mind, so...
You're already doing it.
Don't tell me. You can reject the offer.
You know, that would actually give you kind of a surprise. But I don't think she's that.
I don't know what to do.
What do you mean?
Do you believe in destiny?
I don't know. I guess that depends on how you view it.
When I think of destiny, I don't think of a predetermined fate you can't escape, but rather some sort of final goal, something you work towards your entire life.
Okay, yeah, I can see that, sure.
Well, what would you do if something came along that you never expected? Something that had the potential to stand between you and your destiny?
Like what?
Or what if you could suddenly fulfill your destiny in an instant, but at the cost of who you were?
You're not making any sense.
None of it makes sense. This isn't how things were supposed to happen.
I'm sorry. Please, I'm just trying to understand what's wrong.
I always felt as though I was destined to become a huntress. To protect the world. And it's become increasingly clear to me that my feelings were right. I don't know if I can do it.
Of course you can. The Pyrenee ghosts I know would never back down from a challenge. And if you really believe it's your destiny to save the world, you can't let anything stand in your way. Kira?
Stop.
Did I say something wrong?
Stop!
Oh!
Say.
Oh, you said a lot.
What's this? Oh.
Is that Velvet taking pictures of?
RWBY, how are you going?
Hi, Velvet. What are you up to?
Oh, you know, just working on my photography. Do you want to see?
Oh, yes. Sun.
Is she doing okay?
Yeah, she's fine. Thanks.
I think it's just awful what people are saying about her. Kim's such a nice person.
Huh. Well, I'm glad someone thinks so.
Most people don't know what it's like on the battlefield.
That...
I mean, even experienced fighters can get scared and start seeing things. If it happened to Coco, it can happen to anyone.
Coco?
Yeah. She saw Yatsu with her in the forest during the fight with Emerald and Mercury, but he never even made it out of the geyser fields. Stress-induced hallucinations, apparently.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
She's gonna try and see if something else happens again.
Well... Does that mean Emerald still, like, did Emerald take Mercury's place?
Possibly. That's probably how it will be done.
Emerald's here?
Oh no, it's gonna be, they must have someone else here.
No, I think...
Well, obviously Emerald's here, so where she was supposed to be heading towards Haven.
Oh.
Mercury?
It looks like our first contender is Penny Polidina from Atlas.
Uh-oh.
What are you doing?
And her opponent will be Kira Nico from Vegas.
No.
Ooh, polarity versus metal. That could be bad.
Especially Pyrrha's not in...
Oh, come on! Oh,
in the right swords. She gonna learn how to
have to fight with that. Well, she has speed.
Here is unstable mentally.
I don't know what to say after that. I do think it's funny that the photography thing.
Is that really her weapon?
Is that really what she's been working on all semester? Taking pictures? Was she gonna try to take pictures during the battle?
I don't know. So what does it do? Like, flash people and blind
Maybe you can freeze them in place.
I don't know. What to see?
I almost think it'd be interesting if you could take pictures of people and suck them into it.
That'd be a little overpowered.
Well, I mean, we all expect her to be overpowered.
But how would that work against Grimm? Oh, I can get that. Kirby with Grimm? Just... Okay.
That was...
The next episode's gonna be very, very bad. Clearly, Mercury's been exposed to RWBY, so things are gonna go... Things are turning up.
I have a feeling she's either gonna have to...
Learn how to fight.
Back and run? Or learn to fight, or zoom past him with her speed.
Where was she going?
Don't know. She must have been leaving to go tell someone. Like Ironwood or whatnot.
We'll see. Alright. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode.
Take care.
Bye.